So far, I have been giving you z-scores and asking you to find proportions beneath the normal curve. Now we're going to compute our own z-scores from raw data and then figure out the proportions below the normal curve. Let's begin by computing some z-scores. To apply our z-score formula, we need a mean and a standard deviation for the population. For this example, we have been given a population with a mean of 50 and a standard deviation of 4. We're going to use the z-score formula to find the following z-scores. Here you see the general z-score formula. Let's make this formula more useful by customizing it for this population. Good. Now we can plug in each x value to this formula and compute z. As we work through these examples, I want you to pay attention to the pattern. For instance, for an x of 54, what is the z-score? Remember that the population has a mean of 50 and a standard deviation of 4. So 54 is 4 points, 1 standard deviation above the mean. When we do the math, 54 minus 50 is 4, divided by 4, equals z of positive 1.00. Well, how about an x value of 58? Plug in 58 into the formula, or think that 8 is 2 standard deviations above the mean. Either way, z equals positive 2.00. For x of 62, 12 points above the mean, standard deviation is 4, z equals positive 3.00. Now let's go the other direction. For x equals 46, remember that 46 is 4 points below the mean of 50, what do you think the z will be? Plug in 46 to the formula. Z equals negative 1.00. How about 42, 8 points below the mean? Z equals negative 2.00. For an x of 38, z equals negative 3.00. Now let's start subdividing that standard deviation. What would be the z-score for x equals 51? Now 51 is 1 point above the mean of 50. The standard deviation is 4. Plug in 51 to the formula. Are you surprised to find that z equals positive 0.25? How about an x of 52? The z equals 0.50. For an x of 53, z equals 0.75. We've already done x equals 54, so how about x equals 55? Z equals 1.25. For an x of 56, 1.50. For 57, 1.75. Are you spotting the pattern? Let's go in the other direction. An x of 49, 1 point below the mean, z equals negative 0.25. For 48, z equals negative 0.50. And for 47, z equals negative 0.75. Hopefully, you're starting to see the relationship between raw scores, the mean, and the standard deviation. So let's do one more thing. Let's put the pieces together and answer the question of probability from beginning to end. So for a distribution with a mean of 500 and a standard deviation of 100, what is the probability of randomly selecting an individual with a score above 650? We can see that 650 is above the mean, 150 points above the mean, so the answer is going to be a small proportion of the normal curve. First, determine the z-score for this value. Z equals 650 minus 500 divided by 100. So z equals positive 1.50. Next, look up the z-score in the z-table. A z of 1.50 equals 0.4332. Finally, do the math. Subtract the z proportion from 0.500. 0.5000 minus 0.4332 equals 0.0668. We can move the decimal 2 points to the right and say that 6.68% of scores are above 650.